In this video, with the help of HTML, CSS and JavaScript, we are going to create number counting animation. Not only that, we are going to add some extra features, something like when your number counting reaches to 1000 or more than 1000, we'll indicate with K plus, and also when you reach to 1 million or more than 1 million, we'll indicate with M plus. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. As you can see, I have already created HTML and CSS file, and inside the index.html file, if I type exclamatory sign and hit that tab button, then you will get this HTML5 boilerplate. Now for the title, let's give number counting animation, and now inside the body tag, let's create div with class name container, and inside that div I'm creating header element with class name counter heading, and inside that header let's create h1 element, and just next to that header element I'm creating another div with class name counters, and inside that div I'm creating another div with class name counter wrap. And now if I hit tab button, then you will get this code. So if you have no any idea like what's going on, so this is what you call image abbreviation. If you have no any idea about the image abbreviation, then I have created a separate video on this topic, so you can check it out. The video's link will be in the description below, or in the right top corner you can check out the iCard. For the h1 heading that is inside the header element, let's give the number counting animation. Now let's go inside the div with class name counter wrapper, and inside that I'm creating span tag with class name counter icon, and for the icon I'm not going to use like third party libraries, I'm using emoji as icon. Okay, so in order to get that emoji in Windows, you can press window key plus full stop or dot, and also in the Mac you can press control command and spacebar. If you want to use something like unique or some beautiful icons, then you can use different third-party libraries, something like Font Awesome, Material Icon, Bootstrap Icon. There are so many third-party libraries with the help of which you can give some unique icons, but I'm not going to do that. Now next to that is span tag, let's create another div with class name counter info, and inside that div I'm creating h1 heading with class name counter, and also I'm gonna give data count attribute. For that I'm giving 100,000, and just below the h1 heading let's create paragraph tag, and inside that I'm writing monthly visitors. Now let's open this index.html file with the help of live server extension. Okay, this is what you get in the browser. Now let's select this whole div with class name counter wrapper, and let's duplicate it for more 2 times. Now let's change that emoji icons, okay. And now instead of that monthly visitors, let's give total projects. And also I want to give something like happy clients. And also let's change that data count attribute. As you can see, I have already created the style.css file. Now just below the title tag, let's give link for our style.css file. And inside this style.css file, in order to prevent the browser's default margin and padding, for the universal selector, I'm giving margin and padding 0 for the box sizing border box. Now let's tell this div with class name container. For the class container, I want to give the height of 100 VH, display flex, let's give the flex direction to column, align items to center, and also justify content to center. Now let's tell this header element. For the header element with class name counter heading, I'm giving width of 80 VW. For the height, let's give 35 VH, and for the background I want to give linear gradient color. For the angle, let's give 45 degree. For the first color I'm giving gold color, and for the second color let's give the orange red color, and also let's give the border radius. For the border radius I'm giving 1 rem. Let's give text align to center, and also for the margin bottom I'm giving 1.4 rem. Now let's style the h1 heading, which is inside the header. For that I'm giving font width of 700. For the font size let's give 2.8 rem, and let's give the line height of 35 VH, and for the font family let's give sans serif. Okay, I think let's remove that line height. Instead of that, let's give the display grid for that header element, and also place items to center. As you can see, with the help of that code, we are taking that h1 heading exactly at the center of that header, and also it is responsive. Similarly, let's give the padding. For the top and bottom I'm giving 0. For the left and right I'm giving 0.5 rem. Now when you hover the header, let's give the transform scale to 1.05 and also cursor to pointer. So now you can see when I hover, okay, there is no any smooth transition. So for that, for the header element, let's give the transition. For the transition duration, I'm giving 0.3 seconds. And for the timing function, let's give is in out. So when I hover, now you can see that smooth transition. I'm adding filter, saturate to 300%. Now you can see when you hover, you'll get more saturated color. Similarly, I want to give the box shadow. For the X offset, I'm giving 0. For the Y offset, let's give 0.2 rem. And for the spread value, I'm giving 0.2 rem. And for the color, let's give black color with transparent value. So you can see when you hover, you are getting that box shadow. Now let's tell the div with class name counters. For the class counters, let's give the width of 80 VW. And also I'm giving display flex, align items to center, and also justify content to space between. Now it's time to style the div with class name counter wrapper. For the class counter wrapper, I'm giving width of 32%. For the height, I'm giving 9 rem, and also let's give display flex, align items to center, and also justify content to space around. As you can see, there are three more divs with class name counter wrappers. For each class counter wrapper, I want to give different gradient color. So for that, I'm using the and child pseudo class, and let's give the 1. And for the first div with class name counter wrapper, let's duplicate this code and let's take it there. Okay, so let's give this gradient color. For the first color, let's change it to pink. For the second color, let's give crimson. And let's select this code and duplicate it 4 more times. And instead of that 1, let's change it to 2 and also 3. And for the first color, I'm giving shine. And for the second color, let's give blue. And also for the third div with class name counter wrapper, for the first color, I'm giving medium spring green. And for the second color, let's give green color. I think it's now looking really beautiful. Now let's add extra CSS code. For the class counter wrapper, I'm giving border radius of 1 rem, and also let's give the padding. For the padding top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left and right, I'm giving 2 rem. So now when you hover the class counter wrapper, I want to give this same CSS property. So for that, with the help of comma, for the class counter wrapper, when you hover, we'll give the same CSS code. Okay, so as you can see, when you hover, you are getting the same effect, but there is no any smooth transition. So let's duplicate this transition code and let's take it to the class counter wrapper. Now let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. And now when you hover, you can see this smooth transition. And I think this is looking really beautiful. Now let's tell this span tag with class name counter icon. For the class counter icon, I want to give the font size of 2.5 rem. And also for the class counter info, I want to give the color of white color. And also let's give the text shadow. For the X offset, Y offset, and the spread value, I'm giving 1 pixel. And for the color, let's give the black color with some transparent value. This is what I want. And now let's tell the h1 heading, which is inside the div with class name counter info. For that h1 heading, I want to give the font weight of normal. For the font size, I'm giving 2.8 rem. For the font family, let's give sans serif. Now it's time to style that paragraph element. So let's duplicate this code, and now instead of that h1 heading, let's give paragraph tag. And for the font size, let's change it to 1.1 rem. Okay, and also let's give margin top to 0.4 rem. Yeah, this is exactly what I want. Now that was all about the HTML and CSS code. Now it's time to add that number counting animation. Okay, so for that, I'm gonna use JavaScript code. There is very few lines of JavaScript code, so I'm using the internal JavaScript code. So just above the end of body tag, I'm creating script tag, and inside that script tag, let's create constant variable counters, and I'm assigning document.querySelector all. Okay, so we are using query selector all. It's because, as you can see, we have multiple h1 heading with class name counter, so we want to get all those h1 heading with class name counter. So for that, let's take the help of foreach method, and inside that, let's keep the counter as parameter, and we'll use the arrow function. Now let's see it in the console, what kind of value we are getting, or what kind of value we'll get with the help of that counter. In the browser, if you press F12 key and let's go to the console tab. You can see we are getting each h1 heading with class name counter, and also you can see their data count attribute. Okay, now let's remove this console.log and let's create another variable initial count. For the initial count I'm giving 0 for now, and let's create another constant variable final count, and for the final count let's give counter.dataset.count. So with the help of this we are getting that each h1 headings data count attribute. Okay, so if I have gave their data number, then you could write their dataset.number, but as you can see I have given their count, so I'm giving .count. So now with the help of this code we are getting that data counts attributes value. Now let's console.log this final count in the browser. Now you can see we're getting that data counts attributes value. Now with the help of this set interval method we will add that number counter animation. As you can see, for the second parameter it will take the interval, so it will take that interval in millisecond, so I want to give 1 millisecond as the time period. Okay, and for the first parameter it will take the callback function. Instead of that arrow function I want to give update counting function, but as you can see we haven't created that function, so let's create that update counting function. Now inside the update counting function let's increase that initial counts variables value by 1, so you can give something like plus plus, or it can be written in more long form, so it is the same thing. Okay, but as you can see inside the h1 heading with class counter we have given there 0. Now instead of that 0 we will change to this new value initial count. For that I am writing counter.innerText is equal to initial count, and in the browser now you can see that counting animation, but there is problem. So that counting animation, it's going forever. So in order to stop that animation let's give the condition. For the condition I am giving if initial count, okay, this initial count, if that is greater or equal to the final count, so this variable, okay, final count, where we have stored this data counts attributes value, so which is our final count. Okay, so if initial count that is greater or equal to the final count, then let's call the method called clear interval. So we are clearing this interval. First of all let's store this interval inside the constant counting variable, and let's copy this counting variable and let's paste it inside that clear interval. Let's go back to the browser. Now you can see when it reaches to the final count or the maximum value, then the animation it stops. Now it's time to add the extra feature. We want to add something like when the number it reaches to 1000, we want to indicate with k plus. Okay, so for that first of all let's give condition. For the condition I'm giving if initial count is less than 1000, then we'll give the same animation. Okay, and now instead of that initial count plus 1 will increase the initial count by 5. Okay, so we are increasing the speed of that counting animation as you can see. Now let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Now instead of that less than 1000, let's give greater or equal to 1000. So for that condition we'll increase the initial count by 100, and for the inner text we'll give initial count divide by 1000 plus, so we are concatenating the string k plus. So in the browser now you can see when it reaches to 1000 or more than 1000, we are indicating that number with k plus. Once more let's duplicate this code, and also I want to give something like when you reach to 10,000, okay, I want to increase the initial count by 5000, and we don't need this code. Now let's duplicate this code, and instead of that 1000, now let's give 1 million, and for the initial count we'll increase it by 500,000. And okay, I have done some mistake there. When our counting reaches to the 1000 or more than 1000, I have given the initial count divided by 100, there should be 1000. I'm so sorry for that, my bad. Now let's change that initial count divided by 100 to 1 million. In the browser you can see you'll get that decimal value. So in order to get only 2-digit decimal value, let's wrap this code inside the small bracket, and I'm writing dot to fixed, I'm giving 2, and also let's add the same thing for that million as well. Okay, and now instead of that k plus let's change it to m plus. Now for the first h1 heading let's change that data count attribute to 15 million, and for the third h1 heading let's give 12 million. Okay, I have changed my mind. Instead of that 2-digit decimal value let's give only 1-digit value. Okay, and now remember if you want to just slow down your counting animation you can change that set intervals interval and also this initial counts value. So what if I change that set interval to 500 0.5 second in the browser? You can see the speed of your animation, it's now really slow. Now for the second H1 heading, data count attribute, I'm changing it to 22,000. And in the browser you can see, okay, everything is looking really good and everything is working fine. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.